What's up, guys? This is Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you hit that like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, we are continuing the rendering on the raster data layers, the rendering types. In this video, we'll be covering hill shading. Okay, so I brought in a DEM, digital elevation model, of Hinds County. And we'll go ahead and get into the properties. It is a single band gray by default, but we're going to switch it over here to hill shade. Okay, hill shade is going to allow us to do several things to this raster image. One, you can select whatever band that you're going to work with. Mine only had one band anyway, being a single band gray. The altitude, you can actually manipulate the elevation of the lighting of the image. Where is the light source for the image going to be elevated to? By default, it is set to 45 degrees. I think the range is from 0 to 90 degrees. 0 being the minimum, which is the light source will be literally right on the image. And then 90 degrees is the highest point away from the image that it can be. We also have the azimuth, which will allow us to determine the direction of the specific light source. So we were able to manipulate the elevation. Now, what direction do we want the light source to be illuminating our image? And that is the azimuth. The next thing we have is the Z factor, okay? And this is specifically to manipulate the scale of the scale of the display of the image. Remember, in older videos, we talked about large scale, small scale. We talked about adding more detail. When you scale out, you're scaling out, you're getting less and less detail. Okay, so small scale, large scale, how much detail do you want to see in the image? That's what this is about. The Z factor can go from 0 to 99, I believe. 0 to 99. 0 being 0 detail, 0 scale. And then as you increase this number, you get more and more detail about the different shades on your raster image. The last thing is the multi-directional function here, which means whatever settings that you have set up here, other than the azimuth, the Z factor, and the altitude, will be used in all directions here. Okay, so the light source will be coming from all directions. All right, so let's go ahead and use these. So with the altitude here, let's just take the altitude to 0 first. Show you what that looks like. 0 altitude. We'll hit apply here. That is 0 altitude right on that raster data image. Nothing is being captured. Now, that will be different for different raster data images. Sometimes there will still be something captured there. But for this DEM file, nothing is captured. Let's take it to 1. We'll hit apply. Still nothing. Okay, let's take it to 10. Okay, I see it just a little bit. It's peeking through just a little bit. Very, very small. So let's take it to 20. Very small. And this is the light increasing in elevation from the image. Okay, so let's go ahead and take it back to 45 there. And these are our hills, the hills that have been shaded for this image. Okay, all right, so now let's decide where the light source will be located. Right now it's located off to this direction, so it's shining. Like, let's say if the light source is the sun is shining from this direction across our image. So let's go ahead and move this. Let's say we want it to be shining down here. So it'll be shining from this region across this way. Alright, so let's go ahead and hit apply. And now you see that adjustment. The sun is now shining from this angle going back. Alright, now the last thing to do is the Z factor. Right now we see little details, but we can actually make this more detailed, more pronounced, more of a standout detail. So we could just increase this. Let's increase it to 2. See a little bit more detail. Increase it to maybe 5. A lot more detail. You can actually see the little deviations in there, down in those crevices. Okay, so that is how you manipulate all of that. And the last thing we're going to do is the multi-direction, which is going to basically use the same altitude and same Z factor for all angles. All right, so let's go ahead and apply that multi-directional. And that's what it looks like. It's shining. This means the multi-directional means there are light sources all the way around shining, and it is capturing the median, or the median image from all of those light sources reflecting this image. Okay, and you can always adjust the Z factor in this. Like, I could take it to even more to increase the detail here. But what you cannot change now with the multi-direction is the direction. All right, let me see about the altitude. I believe you may be able to change the altitude. Let's see, 25. Okay, so you can change the altitude, but you can't change the direction. All right, so that is pretty detailed. If you have any questions or comments about the hill shading render type, please let me know in the comment section. So guys, I actually made this video before the last day of the year, but I'm coming and putting this voiceover in here just to wish you guys a happy new year. It's December 31st currently, and this will be the last video of 2020. So guys, we've made it a long way, and we're still pressing on. And 2021 is definitely looking more optimistic than 2020. So let's continue, and let's continue to be great together and learn together for 2021. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.